南敬礼传承祖师。
Let's pay homage to the lineage gurus.
敬礼了明和尚。
Homage to the Venerable Monk 了明。
沙迦正空上师。
Homage to Master Sakya Zhengkong.
就是大宝法王喀玛巴。
Homage to His Holiness the 16th Kamapa and homage to Master Dubten Dorji. Homage to the three jewels of the altar. Homage to the main deity of Homa today, Golden Mother of the Primordial Chitpan. Sumu, Tanzan Katso, Dutan Siti, all Dharma masters, Dharma educators, Dharma teachers, Dharma instructors, Dharma assistants, directors of temples, chapters, and centers, and all disciples present here and over the internet, good afternoon everyone, how do you do?
你好，大家好。I stay. 谢人个。阿拉弥陀。给给龙母笑。是国音。一起吧。提莫吉。啾咪。亚比。布丁布丁。こんにちは。先通知大家。
I would like to announce.
下礼拜天，八月。
For next Sunday, August 28th at 3 PM, there would be the Yellow Jambala Homa Fire Offering Ceremony. That's next Sunday. At the Rainbow Temple, there would be Yellow Jambala Homa Fire Offering Ceremony.Simply said, if you have enough money and you don't need money anymore, or you look down upon money, you don't think money is so big deal, then you don't need to become the primary supplicant.But for the rest, just think about it on your own.
在还没有这个说法之前
，and before the Dharma teaching，
我跟大家，我有几个这一次法会有几个感想。
I have several.
稍微提一下。
Feelings about these ceremonies.
就是我们出过了 school.
That first our true Buddha school.
政治
is
本人是这个样子
not involved in any politics.
也不要去加
That's myself personally.
这个政治
It's personally for myself as well as for the school.We are never involved in politics.
修行就是
修行。We just do spiritual cultivation, nothing else.
但是呢
，However，
是有这个台湾的 president.
This time,
立华
Taiwan president and the head of the legislature.Ministry also give us some
另外、这个、
greetings or whatever wishes, and also Nantou County Mayor, where our Taiwan Lijiang Temple is located. Mr. Li Mingzhen also sent us a greeting card. And the legislator
Ma Wenjing,
Ma Wenjing, Xi Shuhua also sent us some greeting cards. And many other city councils from Taipei, from Tainan. And they are all from Taiwan and many more who sent us greetings. We don't have any political stance. And it's the same in American as well. I am neither Republican nor Democrat. So I have no political affiliation. It's the same in Taiwan. That I also, I only focus on my spiritual cultivation work. But since people send greetings, we offer our gratitude. Also give them blessings to the Taiwan president, and the minister of the legislature ministry, and many other legislators and councils. So I should express our gratitude here. And if mainland China also sent us some greeting, then we will also mention all the same. For myself personally and my and the school, and we have no political stance or alleviation. I like to stress that, to emphasize it again. We are never involved with any politics. But since people send you greetings, right? So you need to say something, right? That's the first one. Second one, someone told me, Grandmaster, have you ever said that you will not guide anybody that doesn't come this time to the Pure Land, that you will not guide those who are not present here today to the Pure Land, okay? So that's a joke, it's not the truth. You know why? Because the pandemic is not completely gone around the world. So those of you who are here today are brave, the brave ones. So, but for the cowards, we cannot force them, right? So, I cannot announce that I will not guide the absent ones to the Pure Land. Someone asked me, no, that's not the case. I will still guide them to the Pure Land, even if they're not here this time. But if you're here today or this time, that I will even more guide you
to the Pure Land.
I will guide you even more, because Grandmaster has stated that I will not forsake any single sentient being. If you ignore and never showed up for years, someone asked me what will happen to them. And all I can say is, There is a statement in Champrayana that the root guru is like a fire, like fire. If your distance is too far, you will not receive his light. But if you're too close, then you would be burned by the fire. So you need to maintain the right distance. So that you have the light of the fire radiating upon you. So that's why, for all my disciples, don't be so far away, otherwise I do not recognize you. How can I guide you to the Pure Land? Because when I see you, I don't recognize you, then how can I guide you to the Pure Land? So don't be too far, but also don't be too near. If you're too close, it's easy for you to get burned. You need to maintain the right distance, and you can still receive the bright, clear light radiance of the lineage. So that's what I mean. I would never abandon any single being. But I'm only abandoned by the sentient being. So I will never abandon sentient beings, but sentient beings are the ones who abandon me. But how do you feel when sentient beings abandon you? Are you unhappy or upset? According to the Vimalakirti, the great master Vimalakirti, that I deliver sentient beings according with the affinity. So if they have affinity, they would come. And when the affinity is gone, they're gone.
有缘的人,
people that have affinity, they would naturally come. And those without affinity, of course, would leave. It's a natural phenomena. Very natural.
Natural.
It's completely natural phenomena. It's not organic.
Natural.
It's a natural phenomena. Because those who have developed the wisdom of true emptiness, you view all sentient beings under the heavens as equal. And in the four immeasurable minds, loving kindness, compassion, joy, and equanimity, and that's called the equanimity, which is of the four immeasurables. So you treat your friends and enemies the same, which means that you treat people that you don't like, that's not allowed. So the lady Vimalakirti says equality and equanimity. So the wisdom of true emptiness means equality. So Grandmaster also maintains this kind of mind and treat everyone equally. If you have a stronger affinity, you will come. If your affinity is very light, you don't even think about coming. And there are also different kinds of affinities. Some people Sometimes come, sometimes go, sometimes come, sometimes go. That's human nature. That's how it is. No big deal. So whether you come or not this time, you cannot force people to come. And it's still the pandemic. It's just that Grandmaster doesn't like to wear mask that much. Like yesterday, I did not. And today, I'm also not wearing a mask. But I cannot say that you don't, I cannot allow you not to wear because it's a very dangerous thing. So whether you come or not this time, I will guide everyone to the Pure Land all the same. And with regard to Grandmaster's lifespan, what will be, it can be right now. And I can stay in the Saha world for a little bit longer too. It's fine either way. It's just that what's mentioned in the Vimalakirti Sutra is that just manifesting or reincarnating according, following to our affinity, that Nirvana and the incarnation are the same, are equal. So the Vimalakirti Sutra also mentioned about reincarnation and Nirvana. Reincarnation is Nirvana and Nirvana is reincarnation. They are the same. So according to what the Vimalakirti states, as long as you maintain your bright, radiant mind, that then whatever you do is Buddha Dharma. But if you lose or you don't have the bright light, clear light, radiant mind, then whatever you do, that would be the roots of your transmigration or reincarnation. However, the great bodhisattvas regard that reincarnation is also according to the affinity. So the great bodhisattvas maintain their clear light radiance while delivering sentient beings in the six rebirth realms. This time, Seng Yen Lu Foundation, managed by my daughter, Fo Qing Lu, has not come this time, but there's a reason. But please don't forget that Seng Yen Lu Foundation is really doing charity. It really is doing charity. And the accounting is very clean and clear. That's how she is. Like all the donations to the hospitals, to the medical equipments, to the needy, the poor, the children, and refugees. We never stop any of those charities, but there's no announcements, no report, and they're not present this time because her husband, Andy and Fo Qing, I think surrogate mother.
代孕的孕母就是帮他们怀胎的孕母，也就是把这个 Andy 佛亲，那么
so,
把这个
Andy and 佛亲
孕母的身体里面。
Find a surrogate mother and then place their basically sperm and egg into the womb about 10 months ago.
就是卢英，我把它起名叫卢英。
So my new granddaughter, which I named 卢英。On August 19th or 20th of this year was born. So that's why Fo Qing did not make a report this time. So I would like to let everyone know that I have a new granddaughter, Lu Ying.
那我观察她
，and in my observation, she also has a great origin.
她是这个观世音菩萨旁边。
She is.
谁是吗？
Okay. I look at this one as a close attendance. Two of them.
农女还是两女？
One is called San Cai and the other one is called Liang Ni or Long Ni. Please check the internet.
是梁女还是龙女？手机，你有手机吗？查一下看看。龙女呀，不是龙女成佛那个龙女，这是。哦，龙女成佛那个龙女，但是呢，她是。
So it's the attendant. The name is. Is it called 龙女 or
梁
女？
是吧？善财也有两个。
There are also two 善财。
一个是才能。
One 财 is like wealth, and the other one 财 is like talents.
是善财。
And the one next to Guan Yin, or Avalokiteshvara, is the talents, good talents.
没错，所以我是记得是梁女。
It's called 梁 she's called 梁女。
不是龙女。
梁 is good.
龙女成佛，名气比较大。
And it's not dragon girl who attained Buddhahood, probably more famous.But the child attendants close, the close followers of Avalokiteshvara is called 梁女 or 龙女. Now we're not sure.
Oh, 有两个版本。我记得以前是叫
attendants attract
这个梁女呢。
But as I remember, it's called 梁女。
大有来历，是观世音。
So Lu Yin has a great origin, which is the 梁女, which is the close attendants to Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva. She manifests here. That's wonderful.
这很好。
I find that really wonderful. Everything is the best arrangement.
那么我希望大家呢，也看一看师尊呢。
And I hope that you also take a look at Grandmaster. As Grandmaster said before, the Sun Yat-lu Foundation lacks some funds for their donations. Because to do charity, we need some funds. So Fo Qing extended her palm to ask me. So I signed my check And then when I took a look at the amount, I was shocked. $750,000. Last time it was $500,000. Now it's $750,000. My heart is like being sliced by knives. Not like that, but it hurts, but so I hope that Chubuddha school disciples can help a little bit with the Sangyendo Foundation. And last time, after I mentioned, there were many disciples who helped and donated to Sangyendo Foundation. And the accountant is the same as the accountant to Bill Gates.
And
he said that Sangyendo Foundation's account, I think it's called the accounting, I guess, is the cleanest. And the foundation directors and members, I mean not members, the administrator or administration never don't earn any salary from it. So Grandmaster and Sumu give them their salaries, but they don't get it from the foundation. Now we will talk about the Golden Mother. The Golden Mother is truly great. It's very supreme. Every night, I perform Bardo Celebrance is this Golden Mother right in front of me in the form of a celestial maiden sculpted by the 10th Directional Chapter or the Dokshan Center in Hong Kong. Every time she's the one who presides over the thousands of Dharma vessels are to deliverance. And Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva. You know, every time I come to the Rainbow Temple, there is an Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva in front of the kitchen or dining room. It's a painting. So every time she's the one who use her nectar vase, the pure nectar vase and a willow branch to sprinkle the water to purify upon Grandmaster. Therefore, every time I come, I will pay homage to her. And the Siddhigaura Bodhisattva is the one at the AV room in the Homa Hall there. Who's helping? And the Amitabha is the one who's hang as you enter the tantric quarter. And they are my three yidams. A very important three yidams. Golden Mother, Amitabha Buddha, and Siddhigaura Bodhisattva. And it's this Golden Mother that's right in front of me. And Amitabha Buddha is the one in the painting at the front part of the tantric quarter. And the Siddhigaura Bodhisattva is the one, the statue in the AV room when you enter into the Rainbow Temple main hall to your right.
进厨房吃饭。
And I look at this Swara Bodhisattva, is the one that is hang before, right before you enter into the dining room.
然后
or kitchen.
思维菩萨，思维菩萨也。
And the contemplation, contemplating Bodhisattva is also helping. Master Mahaprabdha Bodhisattva too is helping.
那虎陀金刚呢？
And the tiger head vajra, is the one at my altar at my southern mountain retreat. My affinity with the Golden Mother is very deep. During the Zhou Dynasty, I have created a connection with the Golden Mother. And then, during the Han Dynasty, during the Jin Emperor of the Han Dynasty, I also created affinity with the Golden Mother. And then later, during the Tang Dynasty, the Emperor Su Zong of the Tang Dynasty, I also created affinity with the Golden Mother. So those are my affinities with the Golden Mother. The Zhou Dynasty, Han Dynasty, and Tang Dynasty. I have connected or created affinity with the Golden Mother. And in this lifetime, she came to find me. And in one of the dynasty, the Golden Mother has several famous daughters. One is Huang Ying, Mei Nan, Yao Ji. And Yao Ji,
Lu Shizhen, 以前有在一起。
Was together with Grandmaster Lu in the past.
这是我所知道。
According to what I know.
又叫做银华夫人。
Yao Ji was also called the Madam Yinhua and Sang Lin, Madam Sang Lin.
跟瑶池金母有关系。
These are things related to Golden Mother.
啊，这一世呢
？And in this lifetime,
也在
people
也在
that are related to me are also here, belonging to Golden Mother.
所有跟瑶池金母的缘分。那简直是没有话可以。
Having affinities with Golden Mother,
所以这一次能够
it's unspeakable.
瑶池金母的点化。
That's why.
我记得有一次
the fact that I could receive inspiration from Golden Mother is because of that. When I was little, I went on a picnic or camping with my classmates. And of course, we had a tent set up. And at night, we slept. And that night, I just did not sleep well. I went with three other friends in a camp, in a tent.
当我眼睛打开
，And then I opened my eyes.
哎，怎么进来？老太婆。
There's an old lady coming in.
进来一个老太婆。这老太婆形容古怪。
And the old lady looked really weird and stiff, extremely ugly. And she drew the breath of my two friends. So like the exhalation of my friends, she inhaled. And vice versa, so my friends inhaled the exhalation of her. So one by one. So I could not sleep, so I saw her breathing in the breath of my friends. So, and when she breathed out, my friend breathed in, and next would be me with my eyes wide open, but I could not move my body, and her face was so close to me. Oh, Mom, oh my God. From afar, she looks like a flower, but up close, it's all mark. And another look, oh my heavens.
My grandma.
My grandma. So ugly and old and dry. She looked just like a witch wearing all black. And this time, as she was about to inhale my qi, my energy, all of a sudden there was a voice. You cannot do this, kid. You cannot take his energy. Did not tell me, but tell. The voice told that old lady, that old witch. I heard it really clearly. And the old lady got really angry and asked, why not this kid? And that a stern voice said, because this child has a mission, a divine mission, so you cannot breathe or take his breath. She got really angry, turned around, and disappeared really quickly. So I thought about this incident during camping, and my friends all died when they were young. One had a heart attack and died, and one when they were climbing and died inside the mountain. So those two friends died. One from heart attack and the other one died during a hike. I have mentioned their names before. Yeah.
Now,
but I did not die. And later on, I discovered that I came here, the Saha world, to deliver sentient beings. The mandate of heaven. That's why today we perform Golden Mother's Homa. I like to let you know. So having this mandate of heaven, I have belief in many religions from Christianity, and there's so many of them that I have followed, countless, and I have paid homage and took refuge in over 30 gurus, many of them. And from beginning to end, I'm truly grateful to Golden Mother. After all, it's a kind of affinity. So all the dynasties of China, Tang, Yi, Xia, Song, Zhou. Okay.
Ah, Qin, Han, Si, Guo, Nan, Nan, Bei, Cao, Sui,
Qin, Han, Song, the four states, northern and southern states.
唐一下三州秦汉四国魏晋南北朝隋唐余下三州唐宋元明清唐宋元明清唐宋元明清到了现在
到了整
个历史的这个
This is the throughout the history, all the dynasties of China. And I was also born in the Western Xia, the Tangut Kingdom, the great, white, lofty country. The founder, Jing Di, and the last emperor of the Western Xia dynasty. There were 10 emperors in that dynasty. And the emperor Renzong did the best.
那么这一次呢, 等一下,
was the best emperor. Oh, and this time, for the empowerment, it would include the Golden Mother's Yidan practice, the eight great healing practices, the Jiu Chan Qian Gong, this the like martial art or Kung Fu, the attracting money, the water offering, instant money, the body replacement, the tiger head vajra, the black face golden mother, the transformation body of golden mother, and many of them, all of them. So by receiving this empowerment, you can practice all of them. Let me have a dialogue with her. She said that all the Dharma practices related to Golden Mother, that Golden Mother will bless, will empower us with all those Dharma practices. And this time she also told me that she knows everything that that I just said, and she asked me not to tell too much. Don't talk too much about the past. Let the past pass. And she also said that you should follow Vimalakirti to learn the spirit of Vimalakirti. That's what she told me. That inside the Vimalakirti Sutra, there are three bodhisattvas. Actually, in the sutra, there are 32,000 bodhisattvas attending Sakyamuni Buddha ceremony. And he introduced over 50 bodhisattvas. Otherwise, 32,000, that's too long, too many. And by chanting 32,000, the names of 32,000 bodhisattvas, the sutra would be this thick. So therefore, only introduce 50, over 50 bodhisattvas. But she told me especially, there are three who are the most important in the Vimalakirti Sutra. The first bodhisattva, as she said, is the equal observation bodhisattva. And second is unequal observation bodhisattva. So check the Vimalakirti bodhisattva is the first bodhisattva be introduced called the equal. Observation bodhisattva. And then the second one is unequal observation, and the third one is equal and unequal observation bodhisattva. Golden Mother told me that these three bodhisattvas are the most important, and they represent three kinds of wisdom. Is that right? I get a bit confused. So equals, equal, right? Not equals, not equal. And equal and not equal. So these three bodhisattvas are very important. And the Golden Mother told me what is the equal observation bodhisattva. This bodhisattva view all sentient beings as equal. There is none of the so-called beauty or ugly, good or bad. Their heart mind is completely equal. That, oh, this one is a human being, that one is a bug, an insect. That a human being is equal to an insect. Simply said, that you are the bugs or the germs. I mean, you came from a round worm, I guess it's a round worm and a long worm combined. So that's why don't look down upon those who fly, those who crawl on the ground, or those who swim in water. They are all lives or living beings. Every human being comes from the worms. This is the equal observation bodhisattva. So they cherish the ants that's crawling on the ground. Or he, the bodhisattva. Whether you're a bird flying in the sky, a fish swimming in water, or any one crawling, in the front of this equal observation bodhisattva, it's all equal. That's how great the equal observation Bodhisattva is. Or equal view. So they cherish all beings, so I cannot just treasure Tripura school disciples, but if you're not, then I don't know. But all living beings equally. That's the first and foremost Bodhisattva, the equal view Bodhisattva, that they cherish all living beings, you cherish all things. And the second Bodhisattva is the unequal or non-equal view Bodhisattva. So this Bodhisattva cultivated spiritually and have the wisdom of discernment, and he knows that in spiritual cultivation there are the so-called superior, middling or inferior ones, and there are also worldly and beyond worldly dharma. There are also development stages that belongs to the worldly dharma, and the perfection stage that belongs to the beyond worldly dharma. And the development stages belong to the mundane ground, and the perfection stage belongs to the sublime ground, or the ultimate truth, okay, the mundane truth and the ultimate truth. So he comprehends the mundane truth as well as the ultimate truth. So he teaches sentient beings based on their spiritual roots, whether it is a superior, middling or inferior, and then teach and deliver them accordingly. And this is called the non-equal view Bodhisattva. So now you understand what is, because he has the wisdom of discernment. He can discern sentient beings, and he would be able to differentiate and which level you belong, and teach the Dharma accordingly. So now you understand the difference between the equal view Bodhisattva and non-equal view Bodhisattva. And the third Bodhisattva is the equal and non-equal view Bodhisattva. The Golden Mother just told me that these three Bodhisattvas are extremely important. So this Bodhisattva comprehends equal and non-equal. It's the most perfect Bodhisattva, which is what Golden Mother just told me, and that, and the Bodhisattva is Vimalakirti. So Vimalakirti is the equal and non-equal Bodhisattva, view Bodhisattva. So he comprehends both the mundane truth and the ultimate truth. The mundane truth is the spiritual cultivation of the Sangha, the ordained Sangha, and the mundane, the worldly Dharma is the spiritual cultivation of the laity. So you still do business, you have career, you have wives, you know how you handle them, and Vimalakirti knows or masters everything, as high as the nobility and as low as the common people, and he is able to give Dharma teaching to them all. And for Vimalakirti is the great Bodhisattva with equal and non-equal views. Vimalakirti says that lust, anger, and ignorance are all Buddha Dharma. Vimalakirti can go in and out the brothels. And he's not afraid. And that's called that the flowers pass through without leaving anything on you. Therefore, Vimalakirti had the wife, the goddess who sprinkled flowers, and he had many concubines. And so, however, he said that lust is also Buddha Dharma. Why is it Buddha Dharma? Because he performed or he did things related to lust with the pure mind. That's why the lust is also pure. Let me tell you, if you have even the slightest attachment or greed, then even the slightest, that would be the root of the three lower realms. And according to Vimalakirti, why is anger also Bodhidharma? Why? Because anger means you cannot endure. You lose your temper. But this fire of temper that is lost was because to teach sentient beings, so that would be called a pure fire. It will not harm yourself. So although you lose your temper, that fire of temper is cool because the anger is due to compassion. So the anger is due to compassion. Therefore, the anger is Buddha Dharma. So with equal view and non-equal view and all kinds of wisdom, then you are not ignorant anymore. Then you know what delusion is about, ignorance is about, or therefore lust, anger, and ignorance are all Buddha Dharma. It's stated in the Vimalakirti Sutra. And it also includes the bodhisattvas of equal view, non-equal view, and equal and non-equal view. So just now, Golden Mother told me, you should learn the spirit of Vimalakirti, Buddha Dharma. This is very high level, very profound. Therefore, lust, anger, and ignorance, everything, all of them are Buddha Dharma. The anger that's due to compassion, lust that's being done with pure mind, and ignorance that's being destroyed with the equal view and non-equal view. And you're always pure and unhindered. At all times. So Golden Mother just told me, you should talk about these three bodhisattvas and Vimalakirti. Only Grandmaster Liu can expound on the Vimalakirti Sutra.
而且可以解释的这么清楚给大家听。一般来讲
，and can explain it so clearly for you. And most people just one sentence, just breeze it through.
一个笑话都还没有讲。
I haven't even told the joke.
那今天大家听了
，so
那接受
after hearing that, how do you feel?
唉，是放屁的皱纹呢。
Oh, this is an article about farting.
放了几个屁，我受不了。
One time,
问谁放的？
My classmates farted several times, and I couldn't.
我捏着鼻子问他。
I couldn't help but ask.Like who farted, and then the person next to him pointed to him. It was so foul, wow, so stinky. What did you eat? And he said, "Hey, come on, you know, you already smelled it, so you want the recipe too."
吃的什么东西也要问。
He's asking what he's eaten.
就他在很早以前的笑话
里。这是 joke from long time ago.
马上要过年了。
It's about New Year time.
考一下自己。
So I give myself an introspection. My look is not good. My figure is no good.
And
my education is no good.My writing is no good. Everything is no good.
同时我也思考了一下
But then I thought deeper. What is the most important question? What makes me continue living all these years then? My eating is still good. My sleeping is still good.
吃饭睡觉也是一种佛法。吃饭睡觉也是佛法的。这个人作文，我真的想做一头猪，不用努力就有吃有喝。虽然生活环境很脏。
I don't have to work hard, and I have food and drink. Although my life condition is bad, but thinking that I don't have to do anything, it feels good. So I don't want to become a human being anymore in the next life. And I have to go to school and take tests and.Do homeworks. That's quite a headache. I just want to become a pig. It's a kind of philosophy too, huh?
这个小明呢，喜欢坐在同一部校车的。这变成。同一部车的一个女同学，有一天呢
，a girl classmate is in the same car，
传纸条给坐在后面的女同学。
And one day, Xiaomi summed up his courage and gave a note to the girl behind him. If you want to become my girlfriend, please pass the note back to me. If you don't like me, you can drop the note outside the window. But after a while, the note came back, and Xiaomi was so happy and opened the note, and it's written.The window is locked.
中午去买这个肉燥饭，老板娘要找我10块钱的时候，不小心手滑，10块钱就掉进了那一锅 鲁若斯里面，我非常的紧张，以为那锅鲁若斯 那一锅、啊、鲁若的汁要爆香了。这个老板娘非常的淡定的讲，没关系。然后拿着这个调羹慢慢的挖挖挖，从里面挖出两块钱。
I dropped a coin into the big pot as I was buying like a braised like a ground pork rice, and told the lady there, and then but she took two nickels. I dropped a dime, but she gave me two nickels.